Do I want USB 2.0, 3.0, 3.1 Gen 2, 3.2 Gen 2 by 1? Ugh, this is all so confusing. What happened to blue and not blue?
Yeah, sadly, blue and not blue never happened. But worry not, friends, I got you covered. This is DIY in 5. Welcome, everyone, to DIY in 5, the show that turns complex tech discussions into easily digestible bites in 5 minutes or less. I'm Trisha Hershberger, and in this episode, we'll go over the variety of USB types out there and demystify the naming process so that you know exactly what you're getting and whether or not it fits your specific needs. If you find the information in today's video useful, please like this video, hit that bell, and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on any future tech tips. USB, or Universal Serial Bus, is an industry standard that determines specifications for cables and connectors used for short-distance digital communications, connections, and power supply. The USB Implementers Forum is who is in charge of naming and maintaining these standards since USB 3.0 came on the scene in 2008. So for anyone out there who thinks the USB naming conventions are a bit confusing, they are the ones to yell at. Let's start at the beginning. USB 1.0 was released in January 1996, although not widely adopted until the release of USB 1.1 in 1998. 2 years later, USB 2.0 was released, bringing with it not only higher bandwidth, but also specifications for mini connectors, micro USB connectors, and battery charging. USB 3.0 was released in 2008, and it was a vast improvement over 2.0's transfer speeds of 480 megabits per second. 3.0 introduced a SuperSpeed transfer mode, shown with a distinct logo and blue inserts in ports. Ah, these were the good old days when you could clearly see the difference between different USB options. But alas, the simplicity doesn't last long. USB 3.0 eventually became known as USB 3.1 Gen 1. Yep, they're the same thing. Then USB 3.1 Gen 2 came out, bringing speeds double what we had in Gen 1, 10 gigabits per second as opposed to 5 gigabits per second, respectively. Originally, the naming conventions SuperSpeed USB for Gen 1 and SuperSpeed USB Plus for Gen 2 were pushed, but never really caught on. And some manufacturers even added the speeds 5 gigabits per second or 10 gigabits per second to their specs to help make it more clear. But most of the industry stuck with USB 3.1 Gen 1 and USB 3.1 Gen 2. Then in 2017, we got USB 3.2 and saw the gradual move from USB-A to USB-C connectors. USB-C supports higher transfer speeds and faster charging, and as such is becoming the new standard. Because of this, we see USB 3.2 in 4 different variations. USB 3.2 Gen 1x1, offering the same speeds as USB 3.1 Gen 1 and therefore the same as USB 3.0. USB 3.2 Gen 1x2, offering 10 gigabit per second transfer speed in USB-C form factor only. USB 3.2 Gen 2x1, 10 gigabit per second speeds in the standard USB-A form factor,
just like USB 3.1 Gen 2.
And USB 3.2 Gen 2x2, 20 gigabit per second transfer speeds, USB-C only. Confused yet? Let's keep going. Thunderbolt is the brand name for Intel and Apple hardware connecting peripherals to a computer. And while the first two generations used a mini DisplayPort connector, the latest version, Thunderbolt 3, uses a USB-C connector. It is precisely this combination of USB-C Thunderbolt technology which will take us into USB 4. USB 4 promises increased bandwidth, 40 gigabit per second transfer speeds, Thunderbolt capability, USB-C connections, and with any luck, intense minimizing of USB user confusion. The good news is almost all of this tech is backwards compatible, and again, hopefully will be more streamlined as we move into the era of USB 4. Do you have any specific USB related questions not answered in this video? If so, please go ahead and leave them in the comments below and we'll do our best to answer them. All right. Thank you everyone so much for watching and see you soon with more DIY in 5.